Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Brand Suicide. Today, we're going to be talking about networks and using one network in specific. Basically, this week, a little bit of beef spawned up on Twitter between my friend Herodic or Will.
What is up, it's your Ryan Skull Ham. Welcome back.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
And his network at the time, ContentPixel. Now, I'm not going to go into the specifics of Will's relationship with ContentPixel and what he was upset about. If you want, you can go check out his video.
So, ContentPixel just made Will take the video down in order to leave their network. So that means the video's gone. So this video's basically over. That's it for this video. End it. Just end it. Just click off. Click another video.
Now today's video is going to discuss a number of topics not specific to ContentPixel. We're just going to use them as our example and relate that to a lot of other networks that do the same thing. So last night, a bunch of people hopped on ContentPixel's case, and a big chunk of what people were talking about was being ignored by the network. Even Will, who had about 200K subscribers, had to make videos or start, you know, something on Twitter just to get their attention over his bad copyright strikes, all kinds of stuff. It just wasn't fair. I actually searched up a number of tweets with the keywords ContentPixel ignore, and there were a surprising number of tweets just saying the same thing. Even my friend Schwepnik, who had been trying to disconnect from them for this entire summer, was blatantly ignored. And when we stirred them up on Twitter, Schwepnik sent them a tweet and said, please stop ignoring me. And they finally said DM. Took all summer and like an entire Twitter riot just to get them to unlink my friend Schwepnik. I mean, the best arguments I've heard in favor of networks like Omnia and such is the fact that they respond sometimes within the day that you send them an issue. Networks like ContentPixel and stuff don't listen, and it's bad for your network. I mean, why? Why? What pushes a network to ignore the people that it's representing? Something's so easy to me. I don't know why this is such a hard thing for networks to do. Unlinking people. Just like with a number of networks like Machinima, Fullscreen, ContentPixel does not like unlinking people, apparently. And that ties well into the ignoring topic, because a number of the people that are ignored by this network are the people who want to unlink from it. One of their arguments was that a lot of the people that wanted to unlink couldn't because they were in a lock-in contract, such as Rage Elixir. That's fair. A lock-in contract is indeed lock-in. You have to serve for the entire purpose of the contract, and then you can get out, basically. But considering this network's already shady behavior, would you put it past them to maybe, you know, be a bit vague and then trick YouTubers into signing lock-in contracts without knowing about no lock-in contracts? Imagine, right? You go to join a network, you get the paper, it just says, you know, here's the terms, sign our contract, defaulting to a lock-in contract, you sign it, you're stuck. Then it's like, oh wait, there was a no lock-in contract? I didn't know that.
Well, you should have read the fine print.
Your soul is mine.
And then would you put it past them to maybe ignore the users, questions about unlinking, contract renews itself, network replies, oh no, it's too late, I'm sorry, we totally missed you, you'll have to wait till the end of this contract. I mean, I'm not saying they do it, this is in no way a 100% they do this for sure. No, I'm saying it's entirely possible though.
I can't believe we could be.
Now, I think this one falls upon ContentPixel more than anybody else. Now, see, when they were under a lot of scrutiny on Twitter, one thing that we all noticed they were doing was retweeting a lot of their supporters who happen to be Minecraft kids. And you can argue that this is normal. People do it all the time in Twitter arguments and discussions. But the thing is that, you know, ContentPixel is kind of a company. And as the night went on, you could tell that their customer service representative got a little bit antsy because he started replying to tweets like this one from Jones. Now, this isn't too bad, I guess. Still, I thought it was really funny. And another thing they did was blatantly deny a lot of things. For instance, here is a snippet from our direct messages. I said, I'd just like to ask, all jokes aside and from a professional standpoint, what drives a network to ignore and not release its partners? And their reply to my message, we don't ignore release requests. And if for any reason we forget to release a partner, we will make sure to do it ASAP. I think that probably, you know, kills my respect for you more than anything else that's gone down the night. The fact that you just blatantly lied and said, we don't ignore people when you ignored Schwepnik for 3 to 4 months. No, it doesn't work like that.
Baby, I'm fine if we...
All right, right, so this video is not attacking ContentPixel. Just as it says in the title, Brand Suicide, this is a video about how you could potentially kill your brand through bad practice. I do hope if ContentPixel sees this video that they take something from it, that they at least take a look at what their recent practices have been and, you know, think about maybe ways that they can improve themselves and take better care of their network people, because there's always going to be kids joining networks because they just want to be in a network.
Testing, hello, is my microphone working? Crippling depression.
And networks can sometimes take advantage of that. Not saying ContentPixel is one of those networks, but in light of this rather comical situation, my friend Haley and I have decided to put together a little song. So, enjoy.
ContentPixel is one of the worst networks. All they do is steal your money and not reply to messages.
Well, it's a definite yes on one of those things. The other one's kind of a gray area.
ContentPixel is proper crap. All they do is steal YouTubers ad revenue.
Just remember, this is a satirical, a parody. It's for comedic effect. Please, ContentPixel, don't sue me.
ContentPixel is the absolute